Oh my god, dude.
Wow.
That's how it works. Yeah, I didn't even know. You're still the technologist.
We just tag teamed the fucking audio. He pressed record, I pressed play. That was a nice moment.
It's like in those movies when like everyone has to put their sword in the stone at the exact moment for the thing to move. God damn, dude. Episode 125.
Wow, 125.
A lot of dude. We've been busy, dude. The schedule is tumultuous. Fucking, I mean, again, you got all these people who are kind of still a little too stuck on the Christian calendar, dude. It's like, step off of it, dude.
Yeah.
Forget about weekends. Forget about your company being like, well, this is my relax time that I'm allowed to... Nah, dude. Fucking stop.
Yeah.
Wake up early. Do your thing. Negotiate time off, dude. Take fucking control of your life, dude. I can't be held to the Judeo-Christian calendar, dude.
I'm sorry, dude.
I can't be dominated by someone's time from 2,000 years ago, bro. I just refuse.
I know.
I just refuse.
What time are you on?
I'm on just flat time, dude. Yeah. No calendars. I wake up like a lizard, dude. The sun comes up and I'm like, I'd better move. And I do my thing.
I better move. All right, here. Dude, this is a sick ramp. I got to tell you this.
Let's have.
Because I know you're ready to start firing, so I want to sneak this in before I forget. Last night, in the middle of that...
Tornado
that came through, dude.
Yeah, dude.
There was a complete tornado.
Where was the tornado?
I don't think the tornado touched Dern. But there was a fucking tornado.
I thought there was a tornado in Pittsburgh.
It was out in Philly. In Philly, it was nuts.
There was a tornado in West Philly?
There was a tornado warning in Chester County.
A tornado warning means they've spotted a tornado.
Yeah, the warning said, get to shelter. Everybody's phone got a fucking warning that was like, get to shelter.
I slept through it.
I looked at it and I was like, nah. No, I'm not. I'm not going downstairs. Like, I'm in bed.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not getting up. If this thing kills me.
I heard like wind going nuts last night, woke up and this was like,
Dude, it was lightning every other... It was literally like every 3 seconds there was lightning. It was fucking nuts.
That nader would have sucked me up, dude, and threw me. Yeah. I was sleeping.
I looked at weather.com and one of the articles was a guy who got sucked out of his house and thrown into his front lawn and he didn't remember how.
Oh, he didn't die?
No, he just woke up in the middle of... He woke up in his yard.
Must have been on the kind edge of the tornado.
Yeah, he was on the outskirts.
He gets sucked up into the vortex.
I mean, it was probably like an F2 or F3.
Yeah,
F5 was sucking him up, dude.
Oh, yeah.
So anyway, at like 3:45, this is going on.
Yeah.
And so then I couldn't sleep and I got on Twitter and... Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, Iranian president.
Okay.
His Twitter is fucking hot.
Oh, I thought he sent out condolences for the tornado in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
He might as well, dude. All he tweets about is American, like, it's crazy.
What's the deal? So that's a president of Iran.
Iranian fucking president.
Israel's. Did you ever read Israel's fucking Twitter?
No. Are they popping?
What? Dude, they have like they did like a... Through text, through like almost what looked like a pregnant belly, and they're like perpetuating evil if Iran is allowed to like.
Oh, they did that like the tweet joke, the thing with the pregnant belly,
something like that.
Oh
yeah.
My god!
Yeah, dude.
Jesus. Yeah. These people are stealing Trump's playbook, and like we should just use Twitter like we're a fucking retarded teenager.
I know. I'm telling you, he changed it forever. Wait till you see the debates.
Wait till you hear this.
Debate's going to be a roast battle.
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad. I was recently informed about the death of @NipseyHussle.
Stop.
And I was saddened to hear about his death. And the other 10 people killed in Los Angeles last week. How can one take someone's life so easily? And then in quotes, baby, don't cry. Got to keep your head up. Even when the road is hard, never give up.
Is he quoting Nipsey Hussle?
I mean, I would imagine that's it, but it sounds like Tupac. Isn't that like heaven for a G?
He might, dude. He might have been quoting Pac.
I think Ahmadinejad quotes Pac. His next tweet. So I saw that and I was like, this has got to be fake. There's no way this guy is tweeting about Nipsey Hussle. And then that's verified. His next tweet was, congratulations, Virginia basketball. UVA hoops.
Really?
This is crazy.
That's fucking nuts, dude.
All of his tweets are like, happy 50th birthday to Mahmoud Abdul Rauf, this dude who played basketball at LSU.
So he, that guy just loves American culture, dude.
Yeah. Well, he was a former student athlete himself. I think he played soccer somewhere in the United States.
But now he's the, minister or something?
I think the president
of Iran. Oh, yeah, because we instilled democracy in Iran. to make sure that we didn't get
attacked. I don't know. I don't think we helped this guy.
We instilled democracy, dude.
We hooked them up.
We set that up. We went in there with guns. We were like, Iran, you guys chill. Better fucking vote you now. You better
start voting.
You sons of and bitches. And
they're like, all right, we will vote for very extremist parties. Yeah, we're like, well, no.
Stop that.
Vote for someone different.
You guys, you just like slander each other once every 4 years and like, you know, like come up with stuff. And
dude, this guy did a 10-year challenge. The president of Iran took a picture of himself.
He just loves the internet, dude. He's probably the only one with the internet in Iran, so he's probably...
he's like, 38 likes, not bad. I said, congratulations, UVA basketball.
So Iran is the enemy of Israel currently, I think.
Yeah, for eternity.
For eternity, so it's like... But he's a democracy, so his social media game's popping right now. Did he congratulate Tiger Woods?
He will.
Trump did.
Of course, Trump and Tiger are boys.
I actually was kind of stoked when I saw Tiger won. I was at the gym this morning. I saw that him like on the TV. And
Tiger's
like,
the best,
dude. He got caught up. I mean, he took a 10-year travel back. He got hit with a pussy tornado.
Sniz tornado, dude.
He woke up in his lawn after a sniz tornado, and his wife was like, "I'm leaving." He was like, "Huh?" Dude, 10 years, dude. Road to perdition. Came back, just won. Puts on the jacket, goes, "Yeah, it fits, dude." Animal. I was genuinely
so proud of this guy.
Everything I see on TV, I'm usually like stupid, dumb. I saw Tiger one, I was like, "Yes!" I was doing deadlifts, I dropped it, and I was like, "Fuck yeah, dude!" Tiger. I was so for some reason, I guess I was like emotionally invested in Tiger Woods's recovery.
Yeah, I was too. And I didn't like Tiger until
he cheated. Until
he got caught with the sniz.
Yeah.
And then I went through a rough patch where I didn't like him.
You were mad at him.
I was mad at him for being a sniz hound.
You were a sex addict blaming him?
Well, yeah. And then I realized I was gay. For a minute, I was upset.
Were you upset with him before he cheated?
Not that he was cheating, because I condone that.
Yeah.
But also, if you don't get caught, it's fine.
Or if you hire a professional. Yeah. Which he did. He did everything right.
No, he was fucking like waitresses.
Oh. Because I know he hired a couple professionals.
Shoney's waitresses.
Was he really?
Yeah, he was a bad dog.
I know he hired some professionals.
He might have been the king, Naughty B.
Dude, Tiger Woods.
Hitting the links and then eating pussy at like a Shoney's.
Dude, he would probably come in with like one white golf glove on, golf cleats, kick off the dirt, and it was just like sniz in bed, dude.
And it's like, oh yeah, also I'm worth $1 billion.
He probably only got down like the dude from GO2 who got walked in on. Remember the dude who gets walked in on who fucking slips his bird in?
Oh, yeah. Game of
Thrones. That was probably like, if you had to talk to Tiger, you were probably constantly interrupting a threesome. Sorry for the intrusion, my lord.
Dude. That was, we'll get into some Thrones. But
oh, dude.
It was because my old man instilled in me some gayness.
Really?
Yeah, he was like, I don't like it. I think his was inspired for different purposes.
Well, no, old men don't like, they hear about that shit and it's like...
Well, no, this is what he was saying. He was like, I don't care about, like, if he cheats on his wife, like, that's not my business. But what I hated about him was he was always, like, the beacon of perfection. He always acted like he was, like, just the best guy in the world. Like, and my dad watched golf, so he, yeah, exactly. But he would, like, do interviews and be like, I work harder than everybody here. He
probably fucking did.
Definitely.
And he fucked harder than everybody here, dude.
Think of all those other golfers that knew this guy was out fucking...
So what?
Sniz. Exactly, motherfucker. But at the time...
I know.
This is me being wrong.
You were disgraced, dude. You were disgraced.
I'm admitting my disgrace.
You're on the left hand of the recliner and you're like, yes, father, yes.
It's like, yes, papa.
I will destroy him.
I will. And then... And then I watched like one South Park episode and I was like, oh, I'm gay. My dad's gay. And now my dad knows he was gay. My dad knows he was gay.
I told you, South Park.
The Gillis boys have come to terms with their gayness.
I mean, dude.
We repented.
South Park got me when they made fun of ancient aliens. I was like, that was the day the laughter stopped on that show for me. I was just literally fully believed it. And that episode came out and I was like, oh, God. No, it was never the person South Park was making fun of. And I was like, oh, God. Doesn't feel good, dude, to be in their crosshairs.
To
like,
be on the other end of
it. When people are like, this show's not funny at all, it's like, oh, it's probably making fun of you.
Yeah,
like,
I would hate it. I would hate it. I was on the wrong end of one. I changed my mind right away.
I instantly went online. I was like, Googled, like, is Ancient Aliens real? And everyone's like, no. And I'm like, fuck.
Damn, you thought Ancient Aliens was real?
Yeah, dude, they caught me in a spot when I was like...
Got you in a rough
chair. They caught me in a rough spot where I was like, I had been high for years every day. And then all of a sudden I watch Ancient Aliens, I'm like... finally, well, this
makes
dude.
Sense.
Dude, I was like, yeah, dude, look at that guy, that little Mayan guy shaped like he's in a rocket. Clearly, he's going to space.
Or taking a shit.
Yeah, I know. Or it was like, a lot of that was based on like fucking people's hallucinations and shit. So, dude, I was in bed with my babe recently, and we were talking about, what the fuck were we talking? Oh, somehow we're talking about like the elderly and like trying to take care of them. And we were talking about like how they get CPR, and I forget who I was talking to about this, but like,
you, like, crush their rib cage.
Yeah, dude, when they get CPR, they'll get like, they'll break their ribs, and you'll just like kill, you'll like crunch them, like you can kill them
like an old soda can.
Well, I was, we were talking about that. I'm like, yeah, people don't realize like when you get CPR, like the whatever they're called, the paramedics, EMTs, have to come in and like they have to do these procedures. So like if you have like someone who's 90 and like they just kind of want to die, the EMTs are going to come there and like, we're going to carry out what we got to do, because otherwise we're, you know, we have to carry out like our life-saving techniques. So you'll do it and just be crushing their ribs and breaking their rib cage.
Oh, like, my God.
They're just in there like, ah! You're just literally just shattering
this
them.
Is worse. Stop.
Let me die, dude.
Don't beat the fuck out of it.
Dude, I was in bed and I brought that up, and then I got a case of the giggles. So the whole, she's like, that is just, I don't want to think about that before.
Well, we've been talking about that for a while.
About just crushing old people.
About like how easy it would be to like, who is that?
Well, that's what I was saying.
That female comic, that old lady.
It wasn't Natalie. I know you're talking about. Yeah, like
it was like, you know, just a front kick.
Well, just one, just Muay Thai leg kick, broken leg, a dead leg would just be a cracked femur. Like you could literally tee off on them.
Yeah, it'd be like a fatality.
I mean, dude, that would be a very sick black market to like sell your elderly to MMA people so they could fully work out. Just like, imagine if you were like a trained killing machine, how satisfying that would be to be like, left hook, cracked orbital, punch the forehead, destroy the brain, and like uppercut and knock their head off. Like you could do a fatality in real life on an old person.
Exactly.
Like EMTs try not to do. That's probably how tempting it is. They probably feel that first rib
crack. Camera zooms in on the rib cage.
Dude, that rib. They probably feel that first rib crack and instantly throw an elbow.
I wonder if it feels good. Yeah, they're like, oh, my hand slipped.
What, to destroy to destroy someone? That's why you can't give your grandma a massage. You can't send your grandma to a masseuse.
I can't even hug
it's
my
like,
grandma.
You ever pop those bubbles in a package? You give an old person a masseuse, you're like, one rib, you're like, mm. Scapula, you're like, a massage, you just fucking crack their scapula. It is so hard not to crack them apart, dude.
Yeah, that's...
That would be tight, or elderly fighting league.
Elderly, you would just have to, if you were giving old people to MMA fighters, you would just have to be like, this guy was a Nazi. We caught him.
Or just be like, you know, this is my old Gramps, dude. Beat him up.
This is my Gramps. This is how he wants to die.
That's the other thing, too. You could start an elderly MMA, and the winner gets to die. So you have to fight for euthanization.
Oh, man. They would both die in the ring.
Well, either way, that would be cool, too.
Yeah.
Because you get it. There's so many old people who just want to die.
Yeah.
They're just like, I've had a fucking enough. I'm sick. I keep going to the doctor, and they're just making me feel worse. If you were like, you can get a gladiator's death, if we gave them, like, swords and shit, and they got, and then the loser gets... Oh. The
it would be such, like, a sad, like, slow stab. Because if an elderly stabbing another elderly, it'd be such a... You ever see, like, old guys fight online?
Yes, I have.
It's so sad.
I know.
They, like, fall over.
I'm talking, like... Yeah, and I'm talking, this would be even older. Usually that's like 50-year-olds. You're talking about, you've seen, like, super...
Yeah, you can get some pap-pap fights.
Yeah, I'm talking, like...
Where they'll both fall down.
End of the road.
Yeah.
You'd have to give them, like... I don't know what kind of weapon they have to give him, some like real, like,
give him like a speed. You can give him some speed, give him some coke, get him fired up.
True, get him fired up.
Get him some meth. Get him going. Yeah,
what is this shit they make out of? What do they make golf clubs with? It's called graphite. Yeah, you have to give him like super sharp graphite, and just let them fucking have at it.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
And then, you know, the loser just gets stitched back together and like thrown out in the ring, or he just like kind of dies slowly in the ER.
Or you could do gladiator, like Coliseum, get like a tiger in there, unleash a tiger. You could just feed them
with endangered species. Yeah, you could save endangered species and just unleash them on the elderly.
Yeah,
like in that controlled Coliseum setting.
Yeah, feeding the elderly to wild animals.
Not feeding them. I'm saying
I would feed them.
Losers.
Just walk them out. Yeah, the losers, give them a weapon and be like, all right, try your.
True, that's a thing. And then if they actually defeat the lion, we'll give them stem cells and like make them like 40 again. It's like, fresh start, bro.
this is actually like borderline exactly what the Romans actually did.
Dude,
they're like, these pieces of shit slaves we have, just make them fucking kill each other.
Kill each other. And dude, it's not only that. It was like people were so bored back then. If you were like, hey, word out, you know, Caesar, we organized a thing, a bunch of people are going to chop each other apart. People were like, this guy fucking rules.
Yeah.
They would love you. The people fucking love
you. The mob, dude.
If you gave them the fucking entertainment.
Are you talking about mob? Are you using the knowledge you gained from Gladiator?
No, I'm talking about...
It was a senator in Gladiator that like gave that speech.
Well, it's just so funny.
He's like, Caesar's playing the game. He's giving the mob...
Yeah, dude.
Blood, and they'll love him for it.
It's that, just bizarre.
Spin in your head.
Pretty much. But it's funny. It was so funny to think that, like, they were like, all right, we'll just, like, let them watch a bunch of people get mutilated. And people were like, yes, dude, this guy fucking rules. I mean, it was probably so fun to watch.
They reenacted, like, battles. They did fucking, I told you, they did, like, sea battles. They would fill it with water.
What?
They would fill the base of it with water. Put some Crocs in there.
Bro.
Crocodiles that give you guys like shitty boats. Stop. You gotta fight each other in boats.
What the fuck, yeah, dude. Man.
Yeah.
And here we get fucking a bunch of dudes on steroids shooting tennis balls, dude. We got cheated.
Yeah, American Gladiators.
That's some motherfucking fucking bullshit,
gay.
Dude. They should have gave one of them a grenade.
Oh, dude, man.
That, I went to, where was it? Yeah, Palm Sunday with my mom yesterday.
Oh, nice.
I went to Palm Sunday, dude. I swear, I've said it 100 times, dude. It's old hat, but I get more and more freaked out. Now that I've been studying a little bit about, like the Roman Empire and how, like, the links to the Catholic Church. Yeah. And, like, dude, you know the, there's an instrument. It was basically, it was like this, like, Asian instrument that was just this weird, it'd be like if a pipe organ could be played like a recorder or a flute.
Yeah.
So it's this big thing, you blow into it. And the Romans expanded on that and made... They had this humongous pipe organ in the arena. So, or in the Colosseum.
Oh, wow.
So it was like... You know, this thing is like 20 feet. Like, humongous.
Yeah.
It's just this gigantic... So the whole time they're fighting, it would just be like... This crazy, yeah, humongous instruments playing. So I'm in the... We're in the cathedral, and I look back, and all I see is, dude, in the back...
But they're playing, like, hockey music during the Colosseum fights?
Yeah, pretty much, dude. Dun, dun,
dun, dun. The shot clock's running out?
Dude, pretty much. They had, wow, they had this, like 40 foot by, like, 20 feet high pipe organ type.
Like, stuff. NHL 94 music, yes, was being played.
They would just be like, blades of steel. No, you were literally... So then, like, I'm in the cathedral. I'm looking around at all the architecture. I'm like, oh my god, this shit is insane. I look back, pipe organ's 20 feet high. I'm like, oh, wow, fuck, dude.
That got you going.
Because I'm thinking about all the Roman, how the Romans just amassed all these weird pagans together and like, yeah, here, you guys just do this and we'll keep you under wraps. Dude, so now I'm in there. I'm bugging the fuck out. When they speak from a pulpit or like the readers, it's shaped like a little parapet thing, like a young pope comes out onto, which is really like a Roman senator would come out to the little like window, yeah, patio and address all the people. So I'm like, dude, this shit is so fuck. I'm so creeped out by this point. And then all of a sudden I'm in there and I'm like, because my mom like fucking loves church, believes all of it to a T. And I'm like, dude, a couple different military victories, like as certain as she is about that shit, a couple different military victories and she'd believe something completely different. Which is like, that's so fucking, yeah, weird how certain people are of that. And it's like, well, you know, if the Babylonians or,
yeah,
someone else won, you wouldn't believe any of this shit. So,
yeah.
Pretty crazy. And then I'm in there just like, oh, God, I'm thinking about that.
Dude, you don't think the word of Christ would have gotten through? The power of Christ?
No.
Yeah, it definitely would, dude. Come on.
Dude, if the Roman... No, come on, man. It wouldn't have.
Come on, man.
I mean, it was... I mean, I was just there listening to the thing. The Pontius Pilate was like, why do you guys want to...
I know. Pontius Pilate the whole time was like, yeah, I don't really want to do this.
It also makes sense why Jewish people don't really celebrate Jesus, because they basically were like, no, dude. Like, because that was the temple that were like, you know, that was like the centralized source of like healing, prayer, and Jesus was like, yeah, you don't... Historical Jesus is like, you guys don't need any of this shit. You don't need any of this weird levels. Just, you know, be nice, yeah, to each other. And they were like... Fuck this guy. And Pontius Pilate was like, this guy's out. He's, you know, he's an old fucking hippie. He's fine. And yeah, they're like, no, kill him.
There's
so, like, no wonder Jewish people, their whole thing is like,
yeah,
their whole religion is, I don't know, what the fuck is it even based? Is it still like inner sanctum like that? Or do they like even like fucks with Jesus at all? Like, what the fuck do they do?
I don't know what's going on with them.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what do they even do? Do they just teach the Old Testament? Like,
I think. Like, I don't know anything about Judaism.
What do they do?
I don't know. I don't think they believe in like heaven or hell.
Dude, they just, I don't know.
I don't know what's going on.
I don't know. I'm like, in my head, I'm in church. I'm like, wait a second. If they negate the whole Jesus story, I'm like, are they just going on OG scriptures? And I'm like, Pretty much, what the fuck do they extrapolate from that and live by?
All I know about Judaism is like synagogue scenes from Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Same.
That's about the furthest extent I have.
And I saw Drake dancing in the synagogue. That's pretty much all I know.
Drake's party at a bat mitzvah.
Yeah, dude, in the Hell Yeah fucking right video.
Yeah, that's a great, cool video.
But yeah, in my head, I'm like, wait a second. Like, I'm like, fuck, dude, that sucks. They were pretty much like, no, like, please kill Jesus.
He was like, what about Barabbas? You guys want to kill this murderer? And they're like, nah, free him. Kill Jesus.
I know. So good that I was bugged out on that yesterday. I got to stop going with my mom. Every time I'm like, I'll go with you. And I sit there and I'm just like, it was to the point where Brittany like grabbed my hand at one point. She was like, are you okay?
Oh, God. Because
I was looking around like, oh God. I was so bugged the fuck out, dude.
There's a documentary on Netflix right now about the road to Calvary.
What?
About Jesus. The days from Palm Sunday to getting executed. You should check it out. It's fucking sick.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's really good.
Damn.
And it talks about all that. I mean, it goes
into the Roman history.
Yeah, what's funny, though, is Jesus got there on Sunday, greeted by the crowds being like, hell yeah, you're the fucking man.
Palm Sunday, dude.
Then within like less than a week, he was getting fucking crucified.
Oh, dude, yeah. He came through and everyone was like, you fuck. Dude, even Herod. He sent Jesus to Herod and Herod was like, yeah, you're fine, man.
Yeah, well, the thing they talked about was this, what is it, Passover?
Yeah.
Passover is while they were all there, right? Why were all the Jews were all in Jerusalem for a reason?
Probably
it's
Passover,
to celebrate
a holiday. Because they had the Last Supper. That was Passover, yeah.
So they...
That was on Thirsty Thursday. So, I think he did that.
Yeah, Thirsty Thursday. He's getting ripped. So thousands of people come to Jerusalem. So, like, the city could fit, like, 30,000 that lived there.
Yeah.
On Passover, for, like, a week, it was, like, 300,000. So the city's just packed.
It's pumped.
And it's packed with the Jews. And the Jews were sick of the Romans.
Yeah,
so like a revolution could happen at any minute, and Pontius Pilate was like, that was like an outpost. Like they didn't have reinforcements.
Shit.
There was only like a couple hundred Roman soldiers. Damn. So they were like, any insurrection at all, we gotta fucking put down right away. So when the Jews were like, this guy's a revolutionary, they were like, okay. Like, we don't care, but yes, kill
him. Yeah, exactly. Like, all right,
like they were like, yeah, any chance that you guys...
Yeah, because they revolted constantly, dude.
If you guys get fired up, we got to nip that in the bud quick.
Well, they kept getting their temple fucking... different leaders would hang a different thing on top of their temple, like an eagle for the Roman Empire.
Yeah.
And Jews would be like, God, fucking damn it, dude. Get off of our temple.
Yeah.
We're just trying to fucking eat goats in there,
dude. Can we live?
Yeah, we're just trying to live up in there.
And then the Muslims, dude, put that fucking Dome of the Rock in there.
When did they do that?
The Dome of the Rock is in Jerusalem.
Is that still there?
Yeah, that's like on top of...
I fucked with that.
Yeah, but historically, Muhammad was never in Jerusalem.
Jerusalem's probably sick. So if you're playing Game of Thrones in the Middle East, you're just like, yeah, dude, our dude was here too. Like,
yeah, that's
we're
what they
build some big ass weird building.
They
built
it on top of.
Look how fuck. Don't they run around the thing and stuff?
No, that's Mecca.
Mecca, yeah.
That's in Saudi Arabia. This one is...
This is the fucking diversity
Dome of the Rock,
dude.
The Dome of the Rock is where Muhammad ascended into heaven.
In Jerusalem.
In Jerusalem.
Like Jesus.
Like on a horse or something.
Yeah.
He just flew away on a horse.
It was as... Was it... So that was way after Jesus did that,
too? Like,
well, if you heard people...
500 years?
That's where the getting's good for flying up to heaven. It's like, you better fucking build your little tomb there so you can, your little horse, you can yee-haw up
and
there.
And they followed Jesus, too.
Like, yeah, they fucks with Jesus.
The prophet,
dude.
Jesus.
The prophet Jesus, fucks with him.
Yeah.
I gotta know. If you're a fucking Jewish listener, just let us know, dude. What the fuck are you guys up to?
What are you guys doing?
But yeah, man, that bugged me the fuck out. Shit, I got a bad fucking grade on my last paper. I was pissed.
What?
Yeah. I mean, it was weird. I was like pissed / stoked at the same time.
Yeah, you don't want them wanting your paper?
Well, the thing was, it was... It was the one I put on Patreon.
I didn't read it.
It was all right. But it was supposed to be like, I didn't get specific enough with the guidelines. You know how the kid goes, dude. I went too far. I took latitude. I just refused to, like, the whole idea was you're supposed to take studies to buttress your point. But it's like, I mean, dude, research now has gotten so wrapped up into the advertising realm. it was like, I'm not going to like cherry pick studies and be like, no, I'm right. But I put that in there, you know, I didn't really like that. So, you know, but it was funny because I'm reading Jung's autobiography.
Yeah.
Same thing happened to him, dude. He'd spend hours writing brilliant papers, dude. And his teachers would just be like, well written, but this doesn't fit what we need. Bad grade. Wow. So I literally read that, woke up, got my grade, and I was like, yes, dude.
Fucking yes, low grade. You're young.
I'm fucking young, 2.0.
You're young, bro. Young, dude.
Exactly. I'm young, dude, 2.0. I read that, and I was so stoked. I was like, yes, dude.
Damn.
And I calculated my numbers. I'm like, I think I'll still pass through, though. That's fine.
Like, yes. Oh, good. Well, it's pass-fail, right?
Pass-fail. So I'll make up for it, dude. I'll blow them away on the finals. No big deal. But yeah, I was pretty stoked on that. I got a bad grade, and I was like, yes. I submitted another.
How bad?
76.
That's not bad. What are you talking about? God yeah, damn, dude. Masters, what bro. A great standard you hold yourself to. 76 when I was in school, I'd be like, whew.
But you need in a master's program, you need to have like an 80 something. Fail is like below 80 pretty much.
Oh. But, so fuck pass fail. You need to have a B?
Kind of, but at the same time, dude, it's so easy. And again, I could have followed the instructions, bro, but it's like once I get on the fucking fucking organ keyboard, dude. I'm just close my eyes and go. Man,
it's
so.
A master's program. What do you want? A master or a slave, dude?
Exactly.
You're not
dude.
A slave to guidelines.
Dude, I
you're
can't.
A master.
I take when teachers are like, you can take some latitude. I'm like, we'll see. Yeah. Like, get ready, dude. Get fucking ready. But yeah, it's funny. I had to do another paper recently where they gave me like sources I should use. I use like one sentence out of one of them, and then just like, check out this other stuff that I blah, blah, blah. Like, I can't help it, bro. I can't fucking help it.
I bet that Ancient Aliens guy failed a bunch.
Oh, dude.
He was probably, sure. They'd be like, you can use some latitude.
He was George
like,
all right. George Tsoukalos.
George, that Greek moron. He was probably like, here's a source. And then the next source was like, High Times.
Graham Hancock's a fucking bull. I don't know what he talks about.
Is he's that just, an aliens guy?
He's like an ancient civilization guy who's always like, yeah, the shit's like way older than we thought. And I've never
read that it. Guy with the guy from Rogan?
Chariots of Fire. Yeah.
The guy that was like, Rogues, yeah. He went to Egypt and was like, look at the watermarks on this thing.
Exactly.
Sorry, guys.
Slam dunk, dude.
Sorry.
I know. But yeah, it's also like, I don't know. If anyone tells me things are like outside of academic purview, I'm like, yes, exactly, dude. You guys are just scared. Sorry. Dude, the paleontologists and archaeologists lobby strong because they wrote all these papers being like, yeah, this shit's this old. And there's a bunch of proof being like, apparently it's like super old. And they're like, yeah, I'm not going to redact my paper, bro. So
I bet
15,000.
I bet they're wrong, though.
Who?
Like the people saying
Hancock?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I just feel like they would have to acknowledge it for the most part.
Nah. Because it's
And there's a timeline. Like like you can chart from Egypt to now.
Yeah. But they're talking about older civilizations that had before that they're digging up and people are just trying to be like they're trying to suppress it, being like, come on, man. I don't want to have to rewrite all my shit. Like,
yeah.
Just fucking, who cares? Yeah, whatever.
10,000
years, 30,000. Yeah. Like, shut the fuck up. So, I mean, I get that. I would probably fucking safeguard my papers, too. I'm like, dude, chill. I'd silence Hancock.
Put him down.
Yeah, dude. Apparently, he was addicted to vaporizing weed for a while.
Really? He got addicted to vaping?
He would smoke so much weed that, like, he said, like, it was bothering his marriage because he was, like, so stoned all the time. But yeah, man. What else is going on?
Nothing. I'm still fucking bugging out on Ahmadinejad. Dropping those fucking tweets.
I mean, dude, it's...
It's so weird. Because in the news you hear, like, he fucking hates the West.
Yeah, but it's also,
then this
like,
dude's sitting there, like, love Cavs basketball.
Well, dude, it's like, also... What? So you have this, like,
I mean, that's why he's doing it.
And there's also this...
Probably.
So imagine this. So you're a world leader. You're following everything. There's a growing dissent in America, you know, you could say, you know, both sides that are getting picked from like different countries. But if you're like the dude from Iran, you're seeing all these people who are like,
fuck America.
Fuck America. Yeah. Fuck Israel.
Just toss a RIP Nipsey Hussle
all
tweet.
All of a sudden you're like, oh, RIP Nipsey Hussle. I love Nipsey Hussle. And you're just like you're trying to cultivate this. Dude, that was my whole argument on my tax paper, dude. It was like, why do we still use these weird cult of personality things based on, why do we vote on individuals when now we have the information to just put up all the issues and let people go to a voting booth and be like, yes, that, no, this, yes, that, no. Like, why do we need like Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump? Because it's not, we're just voting based off like, wow, they're so cool. Like, oh, dude, he fucking dissed her. Oh, and like, that's all people are voting. When now we could just go into a booth, have people debate and set like experts debate. And then you go into a booth and it's just a fucking thing of here's the bills that are scheduled. Sure. And you could go every like every year. Just go in there, boom, 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 boom. Okay, yeah, let's do that. Let's legalize weed. Let's do that. And just do it like that. I mean, there's no reason they don't. There's no fucking reason.
There is a reason.
These weird figurehead.
No, there
people.
Is a reason.
Why?
The figureheads are supposed to be not retarded.
Dude, but
if you let the masses decide every issue, they're gonna be like, yeah, let's legalize just retarded shit to be funny.
Yeah, but you would get more of a washout. I'm telling you, you will get it, that people who do that are way less than you think on a 250 million scale, and they're only doing it to be funny because the system is so stupid that they'd be like, that's why people write in like Seymour
yeah,
Butts.
D's nuts.
Like D's nuts.
Yeah.
But it's also because the whole system's a joke. It's like to watch two people argue who are just clearly beholden to corporate interests. They're just like, they're all bought and sold, and then they just sway people's emotions. So they're like, yes, dude, now Nestle can fucking sell chocolate milk and fucking Cambodia.
Now Nestle controls the Great Lakes.
Yeah, dude, it's just like,
good.
What the fuck? I'm telling you, they could do it like that. But again, yeah, we have a lot of
You want to give the masses that type of power?
Yeah,
it's nice to have some type of safeguard.
Who though?
I mean, dude? You suspect politicians compared to the fucking retards on the street.
Yeah, but my thing is, you could have people.
I understand
who are
what
in
you're
industry
saying.
To just give people, just go debate the issues. People can research them if they want.
Yeah.
And then you just go vote on the issues, and it's like people are informed as they can be, and then you know you go do it.
People will never be informed on that.
What do you mean?
They'll never be informed on the issues.
So still, even if you have a decent chunk of people who are, you could go. You could have just vote on the issues. You don't need all these weird figureheads and people being like.
I agree that the method that they use is weird.
You kind of have to use it because you're corralling fucking morons. So you have to go. You know, that's the old assumption that the general public are just kind of think with their spines and are just complete idiots.
I tend to agree with that.
That is true to an extent. However, it's also like there are things too, like dude, legalizing weed. Overwhelming majority of the country is like, just fucking legalize. It's so stupid that it's not. And for some reason, it doesn't get passed. And that's the bottle. That's the jam when it like that doesn't get jammed up. All the other technologies that get away from oil, it's like they're being suppressed because the oil companies are like, yeah, but we got all this oil and we kind of like selling it at whatever we want. So I'm saying it would stop a lot of that stuff. So yeah, it'd be a trade-off. Yeah, you'd have some
hopefully
dummies, dude. You'd have some fucking
Or you could
dummies.
Get a vote to change the name of the country to like dildo fuckface.
It would not change the dildo fuckface, dude.
I bet it could. It'd be a decent chance. I'd vote for dildo fuckface.
I mean, dude, it would be pretty funny. I don't know. I think America needs to start doing a lot more experimental shit and stop being fucking babies.
I don't know. I think we're number one, dude. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Dude.
When we start to fall, if somebody else becomes number one, I'm down to make some changes.
We are going to start falling.
Are you kidding?
Sure. Yes.
With the dog in office right now?
GDP's looking good, dude.
Yeah.
GDP's looking good, but in 10 years, shit's going to be so wildly different.
GDP's balling. Fucking Tiger Woods is winning again.
I mean, that's a good sign. We need that Tiger
if
Woods.
If Tiger's good, the economy's
good.
It's
a good omen. Tiger winning is a good omen, dude. The economy goes well when Tiger's winning. Yeah. When Tiger starts losing.
I think he started losing right around the housing market crashed.
True that.
When Tiger lost, everyone was like,
yeah,
fuck it.
That's pretty much a thing. But yeah, I'd be curious because, like I said, there is a bunch of fucking morons who would be like, you know, make like Duck Dynasty theme song, the national anthem. But you'd have to have people who work in pushing the issues out the votes. So you'd still have a body of governance. It's just like the head person in charge based off of like, I'm fucking cool. It's like, all right.
I agree that sucks.
Yeah.
And the way they're doing it, like fucking Beto O'Rourke fucking.
All of that, dude.
Standing like, on like coffee shop counters giving. I think we might have talked about it. He gave a speech on reparations that was like one of the corniest fucking things.
First off,
and he does these hand motions, like real presidential hand motions.
I hate that. Thumb to hand.
He's like, first off, let me say, great question. And I also should preface this by saying, as a straight white man, it is tough for me to even discuss these issues.
I'm done. We need to go.
And it's like,
well, here's my thing, dude.
He didn't answer anything about reparations. He just explained black plight.
That's all he did. I'll answer reparations. Because here's the thing, though.
Yeah, you see Georgetown?
What happened?
They're dishing out reparations to slaves that were sold in Georgetown, I think.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, something like that. Somebody posted Chinese kid that looked like me on Reddit.
I saw that. I don't know. I didn't even get that.
I read the caption. That's as far as I know.
Dude, and this is the thing. For some reason, like, Native Americans got buff-fucked pretty hard. We kind of gave them shit. We gave them fucking casinos. And the other argument people use when Native Americans go to anti-immigration rallies and they're like, you guys are immigrants. It's like, yeah, dude, exactly. We don't want someone to do what the fuck we did to us, dude. So it's like, that's almost a bad argument. People are like, you guys are immigrants. It's like, yeah,
yeah,
I know. Look how bad we fucked you guys. Yeah. So, like, no more. Yeah. But I mean, yeah, I'm not, that's not my thing. But it also, yeah, we kind of gave the Native Americans shit.
We gave them
stuff, dude.
We gave them the worst land possible.
If you're like,
here's your reservation.
If you're in a tribe, tax-free, federal tax-free. If you're in a tribe, I mean, it sucks. Don't get me wrong. The casino revenue. If you belong to the tribe, my boy was working with these two dudes who were Native Americans, or one of them, and they would get a check every month for like 12 G's from casino revenue.
They got a monthly check for 12 G's.
I'm not saying all of them get that.
Because I don't think the rest of the boys are getting that.
I'm not saying all of them get that. But my friend was saying, like, this dude would get a fat ass.
What tribe was
check.
He a part of, dude?
I don't know, dude.
God damn.
But they were getting, he was saying they would just ball at, they would save their checks, him and his brother, and just throw, like, crazy parties in Atlantic City.
What?
Yeah, dude. But I'm saying, it's like, I don't know the exact full picture. I know when it's like, well, Native Americans get their shit, people are like, okay. When people bring up reparations, everyone gets fucked up about it. They're like, what the fuck? And it's like, so it goes down to the thing, like, did black people get butt-fucked, yes or no?
Yes.
They got butt-fucked, yes.
Yes.
Here's an easy thing I think people can do, is if you're black, you go to college for free. That way, it's like, it's not a, you know, you're just sitting in a room listening to people talk. You get to go for free. That end of the discussion. And if you get into the school, take it, dude.
Yeah.
That's, to me, is fucking fair. It'll people will freak the fuck out because they're just like, what the fuck? But it's like, they did get butt-fucked. So Native Americans got butt-fucked. Black people got butt-fucked. Native Americans got butt-fucked faster and more furious. Black people got, like, slow-dicked over, like, hundreds of years.
Yeah.
So it's like, dude, it's not a popular, and it's a nightmare to unravel. But that the easiest one is free college. You could do that, and people will be mad, people will be pissed, but at the end of the day, it's like, college, and any college is like, you don't believe in that? And they're like, fine.
Sure.
Like, what colleges are? I'd be like, fuck no, dude. We're not doing this shit. Like, Harvard will do it. Harvard will be like, yeah, fine, no problem. I mean, dude, it's going to be uncomfortable. It's going to be uncomfy. But, I brought this up in class.
I don't think we need to confront reparations.
You don't think so at all?
No.
What do you think we should do?
It's fucking that happened.
Yeah, but why did the Native Americans get so much money and shit?
They got casinos.
Yeah.
That's it.
Dude, that's a lot of fucking money.
For a few
tax
people.
Tax-exempt status. If you're in a tribe, again, if you're Catholic, I know because I said this in class. Everyone's like, Native Americans pay taxes. You got to be in a tribe. If you're in a tribe, you get taxed. You don't pay federal tax, right? But you got to live in a fucking reservation. So I don't know. They're not like.
Yeah, you got to live in like
out,
fucking Oklahoma.
That's their spot, dude.
Some dirt. That's.
I don't know. I don't know what it's about. I don't know about the fucking reservation. But it's interesting. People want to, like, if they were voted, like, new thing for Native Americans, people would be like, fucking, all right, fine. But when it comes to black people...
Yeah, there's also, like, five Native Americans.
I know, there's not a lot.
So it's like, yeah, just let them do whatever they want.
Dude, I mean, I'm saying free college is a nice middle ground. It's easy. It's just like, yeah, dude, fine. You get a college for free.
I agree.
Free college, dude.
Free college.
You get a college for free, man.
If you're black, what if you have nothing to do with slavery?
Hmm?
How do we decide whether or not you
I mean, we could
had
go,
anything to do with
this
slavery?
Is my other idea. Then I don't. Nobody likes this.
What if
this?
You were a free man?
This is my idea. Nobody likes this. Is we go back in the records, find out who had them.
Yeah.
You got to fucking pay. If you had them, fork, dude. You got to pay.
Now? For historical
yes.
transgressions?
Yes. If you're
wow.
the descendant...
These are some dangerous ideas, Matthew.
I don't care. If you're the descendant of slave labor, if you're a direct descendant on the books of slave labor, and you guys have... like you're like now just a trust fund kid now at this point. Just pulling in money from, like, ancient fucking assets. Yeah, dude, you got to pay child
really?
Support.
These right? are very socialist ideas you have.
Dude, I'm...
Real leftist.
It's not... Well,
real commie type shit you're dishing
out. It's not commie, dude, but if you had them, bro.
What, when they were legal with the government?
Yes.
Why?
If you had them.
It was legal.
Wow, you love slavery.
No, I'm just saying.
If you had them, you got to pay.
So if you did something that was legal at the time?
Yeah.
Now the government's going to be like, well, we changed our mind.
Dude, the government's, yeah, there's no one.
Like, that was legal, but now we're going to punish you for it, even though you didn't have slaves after we abolished it.
You committed an act against God, dude. Now you got to fucking pay. Right. I'm not pertaining to fucking man-made law, bro. I'm only covered by cosmic order.
This is...
What do you don't like?
I don't like this. A little Stalin-esque coming out of
Maddie. If you had him, bro. If you had him.
Old Maddie Stalin.
Hey, man, if you had him. If you never had him, hey, don't worry. You know, kick back. If you had him, you got a fucking fork. You can't have had them and be fucking living the good life, dude. You got a fork. If I had them, which I don't, I'd be like, yeah, man.
Which I don't, currently.
You know what I'm saying? Which, like, sorry, bro. My stock just didn't have them, bro. We came here too late. My thing is, like, you got a fork. If I had them, I'd be like, yo, fucking, you know, come out like a little. I mean, it's never going to happen.
Yeah, you would have to check the genealogy. Maybe somebody married into your family at some point.
You get a lot of name changes. Bro, you know, look, if I was tainted by having them at some point in some form.
How many people had to have them for you to...
I don't know. I'm just a theorist, bro.
I'm telling you, this is
you
a bad
had them,
theory.
Bro. You got to pay.
You got a bad theory going.
Nah, if you had them,
I'm trying to help you out.
I don't need it. I'm telling you, if you had them, fork.
Dude. How much?
I don't know. I don't know how it would work. I don't know how it would work. I just know if you had them, dude.
If you had them, the government's gonna say.
I just want to know who had them. Some people are on Facebook like, man, you could click a button. I'm like, oh, I'm sorry, but you had them, so how about you fucking shut up? Oh, looks like your great-great-grandfather had them, so
yeah.
Block. Yeah, if you're, that's what you should do. If you had them, you can't go on Facebook. If you get caught fucking, like,
that I can agree
lecturing
with.
People on Facebook, you could check and be like, oh, sorry, but your grandfather had them, so.
Sorry, I'm checking the books here, the old ledger. Your last name shows up on a lot of ledgers.
Turns out you had them, so goodbye. Block. I don't know. They should find out who had them.
Oh, fuck.
But yeah, I don't know. Again, the two-party system needs to go.
Yeah.
Because it's the whole point is to corral people in, like, well, if you believe this, you can't believe it. It's like, no. Block. That's all done. What are the issues? I can fucking sit in the Matrix and make pop a ping, ping, ping. Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, but if you sit people down the Matrix to pick those... They're not going to understand the Reaper. They're not going to know enough.
No, here's my thing. You got to take a test.
Oh, yeah, dude. Uh-oh.
Yep.
So now you're denying voting rights.
No, I'm not denying voting
rights. You are. You're going to make people pass an academic test to be able to vote?
No, because if say you couldn't read, you'd have someone read the issues to you. You'd have an audio. You could click. Okay. So if you can't read, boom, you get audible. It's just like,
what if you fail the test?
Blah, blah, blah. What do you mean?
If you don't know the issues, what's the test?
Well, here's my question. Are you allowed to vote if you're retarded?
Yeah, I don't know.
I think you are.
I would imagine. There's no IQ test to vote.
Yeah. So
here's my question.
What?
Are there any gay retarded people?
Are there any gay retarded people?
I had a horrible joke.
Shit, are there?
About how, like, being gay I don't think being gay is a choice, but one piece of evidence I have is anybody that can't make a choice is always straight as fuck. Retarded guys love tits.
Yeah, are there any gay retarded people?
I don't know. These are the questions. Jews, what do you believe in? Retarded guys, are you gay? Can you vote?
Yeah, dude. Well, I mean,
did you have them?
Did you? That's the question. That's nobody the wants to answer.
What if all retarded guys had them, dude? What if there's a genie curse? That's how you get Down syndrome. You're descendant because you had them.
You had them?
Yeah.
Well, a lot of people had them through the ages. That's the other thing.
Uh-oh.
What?
Uh-oh.
What?
Now you're talking. Now you're cooking. So now we're going to go back and be like, hey.
No.
Your descendants were African.
I mean, they could do country.
African slave traders.
They could go country specific.
What if you went back and
now
you got some African slave traders?
You traded them, dude?
Now you don't
have
them.
You got a lot of Ash Ketchums over there.
Yeah, there's a bunch of... Dude, they're catching them all.
Over on the east coast of Africa, there's a lot of young trainers over there, dude.
East and west, throughout. Yeah,
dude. Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of Ash Ketchums, a lot of Brocks. That was his buddy.
Yep.
Yeah, so I mean...
Now, see, when you open the door
Pandora's box,
historical...
Dude. Oh, yeah.
What did your ancestors do? And now we're going to punish you now?
Well, punish. Just share.
Definitely punish. I mean, that's
not
exactly
punish,
what a punish.
Just share.
Just share? Very communist terminology.
I'm not a communist. I'm not
we're not going to punish you. We're just going to share the money you have.
You to share. No, I'm not a communist. I don't believe in communism. But my thing is... Again, it's so annoying because it's brought up as like... It's kind of... I mean, look, maybe I'm wrong. It's kind of their abortion now. like the right has abortion, we're like, we're going to fucking repeal. It's never going to happen.
But yeah.
Everyone, like my mom's like, yes, dude, smash the fucking button. Now the left will just kind of be like reparations.
Now all of a sudden reparations is back at the, in a debate because it's like, well, we love black people the most. We want reparations. It's like, no, you don't. First off, no, you don't.
I got to hear what you're proposing.
Yeah.
If you come up with a fucking sick ass proposal. My other proposal
We're just trying to get black people paid, dude. Here's my other proposal. That's what we're all about.
Here's what I'm about.
Yeah.
Give black people Facebook, dude.
It'd be funnier.
Dude, just let them all money from just coup Zuckerberg. Like, here's your money. You're done from now on. All Facebook's money goes to black people.
Which black people? Just all?
All of them, dude.
All black people.
All of them.
Damn.
All of them, dude.
I love it.
That's not a bad plan. That's great. Black people get Facebook and Twitter.
Wow.
Just be like, you guys can have these and just fucking do whatever you want and take all the money from them.
How do we decide if they're black enough?
I don't know. Oh, it's same like they do it with Native Americans.
Okay.
I don't know. It's fucking, they're black. If they'd have a council
what
of...
What if you had
so
them?
So you have a council of black Israelites.
What if you're half had them and half black?
You got a fork, dude. You got a, you would be what? Like a weird draw. You'd get a little bit. It would cancel out. You'd get a little bit of money. You'd give a little bit. It'd cancel out. What you'd have, though, we'd have a Supreme Court of black Israelites, and they would tell you if you get reparations or not. All right.
Now we're talking.
So you'd get a Supreme Court of black Israelites, and you'd approach them and be like, my lords, can I get... Yes. They're like, get the fuck out of here, you white motherfucker. You're like, God damn.
Damn it, I'm white. I knew I was white. You'd have to show them some moves. Exactly. You'd have to show some dance moves, and they'd be like, oh, all right.
Definitely do something.
You actually are black.
Or you'd have to just be Tom Arnold, dude. Or no,
Tom Jones.
Tom Jones. Yeah. You'd have to be Tom Jones.
If Tom Jones approached them, they'd be like, oh shit. You black as fuck, man. He'd be like, what? Tom Jones would be like, what'd you fucking say to me? You cocksucker. You're black.
Yeah, man. I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do. Dude, it's like the... I mean, it's very different, but the whole... Jersey's trying to legalize weed right now. And know what they're hung up on? If they legalize weed, this governor, someone in their political system is like, all right, if we legalize weed, we should also go back and release anyone who's in jail now.
For sure.
For weed. They're like, well, how much? And they're like, 5 pounds. 5 pounds or less, you're out of jail. And people are like, that's way too much. That's like, I mean, how about you just release everyone who's in jail for fucking weed? And just be like, same thing. Oh, this was fucking stupid. We should probably relax on this. This makes no scientifically, there's no sense in terms of like harm reduction, all that stuff. Alcohol and cigarettes fucking decimate people.
Yeah.
So it's like,
I don't agree with people getting locked up for weed. I don't.
Yeah.
But the argument is like what it takes to run a illegal enterprise like that usually requires some kind of shitty.
Like what? Like, you don't have to kill people to sell weed.
It depends how much.
That's conspiracy charges.
Yeah.
So, and like, even if, like, say you're, like, a grower in California, you can peacefully mail tons of fucking weed. And if it comes to a crossroads where now you're going to shoot somebody, it's like, dude, that's
like... Yeah, I guess you'd be in jail for shooting someone.
Yeah, dude, you're on a murder pinch. Yeah, and like, if anything causes the murder, and it's the black market and it being illegal itself.
Yeah, but then there's still a murder.
Yeah, but there wouldn't be if they didn't have the black market.
Yeah, but there was a murder in this theory, in this where? Hypothetical.
The overwhelming majority of like people selling, it's not like Sicar. It's like,
I know.
You get cartels
that
get into it and like murder people for real. But it's also like, if someone was like, the whole thing is, the whole argument based on the fact that it's illegal is stupid now. And everyone's kind of like, this makes no fucking sense. And then it's like, they start decriminalizing it, which makes less sense because it's like, you kind of can have it. So that's what I'm saying. They're hung up now being like, well, we have to let everyone out now because of this dumb bullshit. Dude, and if they start going down that rabbit hole, the fucking jails are empty.
Good.
Exactly. But yeah, they get too much money, dude. If you can trap someone, make them pay work for 38 cents an hour, bro, it's like, you're not giving that up.
Yeah, that license
that's
plate.
Who has them, bro.
Of course.
They literally...
Yeah.
There's companies that use
13th Amendment.
Exactly. They use slaves. They still use slaves now.
Now we're talking.
Now we're cooking.
Now
dude.
We're getting into it. Now
yeah,
who
we
has
followed
them?
The fucking money. That's what we did.
We followed the money. It was easy. Bam. We started all the way back in Egypt and Rome. Now we're all the way. We did it. We're up to the 13th Amendment.
Bam.
Wow.
Dude. Wow.
I mean, you can listen to hardcore history or you can listen to this.
Exactly.
Same level of like, whoa.
Same level of scholarship,
and
dude.
Again. And we had them again.
And then they had them now.
And now we have them again. And now Nike's profiting off of having them again.
Yeah, dude.
Dude, you should see the new billboard.
What is it?
We on my way to work,
just, we have said, them.
Hey, Nike, we had them. Nike, we still have them. Oh my God. It's now they're selling Colin Kaepernick jerseys that are black.
Nice.
Just the number 7 and Kaepernick on the back.
I'm definitely getting one.
And so there's billboards of a bunch of people wearing Colin Kaepernick jerseys. I'm just walking to the fuck. I'm like, what the fuck is this? Take it easy, Nike.
Can you be any more like pimping people? Any more obviously pimping people?
Yeah. They put like light skinned black models wearing Colin Kaepernick jerseys, like doing cool poses. And all these honkies are walking around New York like, well, that's cool. That makes me feel better. I support that.
Yeah, whatever that is.
Yeah. What's that, a black guy? I'm on that.
Yeah, man.
I mean, I'm just so torn up about Nipsey Hussle.
I mean, that's the funniest part is this. It's crazy to think how important that's going to be to the 2020 to be like, who's cooler with black people?
Trump.
For right now, I mean,
black people hate Trump.
They do, but I'm telling you, there's a lot of people coming out and like, dude,
Tiger Woods, Kanye's album's probably going to drop before 2020.
I think he made a deal with Trump. Ooh. I think he's going to drop it before 2020. Ooh. Did you see AOC getting made fun of for using a black voice?
Oh, that was brutal.
Ain't nothing wrong with being a bartender. And she flipped it around and was like, that's my fake voice. My real voice is more like a black voice. But it's like, we all have a little black Israelite inside of us. Yeah. When someone's toning down, like, if they have like a, like what she's saying, like a predominantly like urban or black accent,
yeah,
you can tell when someone's trying to church that up of like more official versus when someone's like, blah, 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 and it's like, what's up, y'all? Like, she was way on that side of the spectrum. There was no hint of like.
Well, if you have a predominantly black voice,
yeah,
and then you try to church it up, usually what happens is you slow down and then try to use big words inaccurately. That's what happens. You're like, well, what, right now, sir? Sir, I'm being expeditiously right now. Yeah.
You better handle that shit expeditiously.
Yeah, that's what he was doing, dude. He tried to turn it on for a sentence and it came out retarded. He's like, what you need to do is fix this expeditiously, son.
Yo, how funny was that?
Oh, that was great.
Everyone like, I mean, I'm not saying it. Everyone went on to...
Oh.
That's also a weird thing now.
To film yourself in it, like the backseat of your car,
smoking
like,
a blunt.
Shit, this got me fucked up, Nipsey. Yo, I know you young, dog. You young, but you need to fix this.
Yeah, dude.
And like lick your lips on Instagram also, Live.
I know every. It's funny too now. Every just like regular ass dude can just go on YouTube and be like, actually, I'm deeply entwined with a criminal syndicate so much so that I can't be a famous rapper. But check this out.
Yeah,
you're like, I'm not saying I'm gonna kill you, but. Something's going to happen. 45,000 views. It's like, Jesus Christ.
Dude. Oh, man.
Yeah, man. That's a... Dude.
AOC
went hard on it.
Brutal.
But that was
She's rough.
Ain't nothing wrong with being a bartender or folding clothes for people. And she's like listed all these shitty fucking jobs.
Yeah, and it's like, hey, how about you empower these people?
Yeah, dude. Well, then, they played a clip of Hillary Clinton. She went like... whole hog 5 years ago being like, and I rose. She like did this crazy voice. They had Joe Biden's like, and they're gonna put us back in chain. Dude, they've been going hard black voice for, and again, these are, you know, they're cropping stuff like everyone does, but still, just watching it, it's like, Jesus.
I get it. It happens. I've seen a bunch of honky comedians go into a black room.
Yep, exactly.
When you get the microphone in front of a church full of black people,
yeah,
it's hard not to live out that fantasy.
Hard not to be like,
and I said, black people have bigger dicks than white guys.
Yeah, dude.
Would you 69 your dad? Yes, sir.
Yeah, man.
I'd be on top out of respect.
Yeah, dude. It's so hard not to do that. And plus, they were at it. Was it an Al Sharpton event? So Sharpton was there fucking, or was Sharpton or Jesse Jackson? No, I think Sharpton. Jesse Jackson's kind of just chilling now. I think the alternate between who's fat and who's not. I think Jesse Jackson's fat now and out of the limelight, and Sharpton's skinny.
Sharp Dog lost weight. He looks good.
Dude, he fucking thinned up.
He looks retarded. He looks crazy.
I know, dude. Well, yeah, so they were all at the thing. So it was like,
You saw, I think we've talked about that, Sharpton selfie. Have you ever seen
that? Oh, dude, is that when he's like ripped?
Oh, I'll show you.
So yeah, they're at an event. Dude, at the event, it was just like a bunch of, more or less, a lot. This is just like, again, the stuff I saw of it. But it was just like a lot of white politicians having to go up and show up and be like, do you believe in reparations? And they'd be like, yes, I do. And then like just walk away from it. It was just like, that's all it was. It was just, and then AOC was like, ain't nothing wrong with being a bartender. Dude, I heard that and I was like, Jesus Christ.
Jeez. God.
I mean, yes, it's like, my thing is how like.
This Al Sharpton selfie is so fucking funny.
What the fuck is that, dude? That's actually hilarious. Oh my God, dude, what is that?
It's, I don't know.
I mean, the other question is like, how, because it's pretty.
Sorry, we're just looking at the Sharpton selfie.
I mean, dude, imagine the amount of selfies these guys send to get pussy.
Oh my God, dude. Speaking of selfies.
What happened?
Did we ever get to the bottom of that dong?
Nah, I'm going to see her. I'm going to see her, I think, this week.
You still have that picture?
Somewhere. I got to check it.
Boy.
I got to look for it. Isn't that crazy?
I can't get it. It's been in my head for a week. This dong stayed in my head. I've just been thinking about this dong.
I'm checking, dude. If there's a different dong on her phone when I pick it up, I'm going to smash her phone. I'm going to go outside.
You're going to smash the lass's phone?
I'm like,
ain't nothing wrong with having dongs on your phone, y'all.
Dude.
How dare you?
Did you watch the clip?
Of AOC? No, I didn't. I heard about it.
Yeah, man. It was pretty wild. Although, I do think that there is a lot of money right now. And again, I could be wrong. Could 100% be wrong. But like, if I was the GOP, all like these black conservative bloggers, I'd be fucking drowning these motherfuckers in money. Just be like, keep putting out content. Because there's a lot of black conservative vloggers that go on and shred all this stuff. And it's so funny. It'd be just them being like, fuck this shit. But if I was in the GOP, I'd be like, yes.
You'd be funding the black conservatives.
Yeah,
dude. Well, of course.
That's
our political party.
Basically, yeah.
Well, you're more of a black conservative than me. You're a British classic liberal.
I'm a now, classic British
now
liberal.
Now Stalin socialist.
Black anarchist. Dude, I'm telling you, I'm an anarchist at heart.
Okay.
Destruct the party system. Stop it. This is stupid.
You're a conservative anarchist.
Black conservative anarchist, yes.
Yes.
With a little bit of classic British liberal.
Sure. There's a dash of classic lib. Just a dash.
I'm whatever Jordan Peterson says he is politically. I'm a black conservative. I'm an anarchist. Dude. And I also support reparations, dude. But,
bring up reparations to JP.
You got to find out who had them.
Oh.
JP?
He would come down
on you. JP probably didn't have them. He was up in the Saskatchewan.
He would bring the fucking hammer down.
JP? I could talk to JP.
You're going to look up their historical records? What have you done? What have your people done?
Check it out, dude.
What atrocities have your people committed?
Look into it.
Throughout human history, we've all done horrible, terrible things.
Yeah, but why do Native Americans get paid then?
All right, so I think an easier solution is to stop paying them.
You take back the casinos?
Give us the Cassinis, you dirty fucking savages. Give us the Cassinis back.
How about this? We could also do a thing where, like, nah, that doesn't work.
I was saying, what?
We could just give Native Americans coffee, make you guys get control of all coffee supply.
Well, then you're taking away from indigenous people.
They might go over there and have, like, they might go over there and they might go to a fair trade and just fucking take over.
We should give them hoverboards.
Not bad.
Hoverboards. Native Americans, you get hoverboards.
Like, good ones? Don't give them that bullshit.
The old ones.
What? The ones that explode?
Yeah. Give them that. That'll be like our new smallpox blanket. It's like, oh, here's a cool thing they gave us. Oh, it's killing us? It's killing us.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, man. Who knows? I don't have all the answers. So I'm just saying, it's time to fucking step back from the political apparatus of the United States and go, all right, this fucking makes no sense.
Yeah.
Let's find out who had them, first of all. First and
step
foremost.
Step one.
Let's use all of our CIA.
Regardless
of what's
going on.
We should use CIA, all of them, to find out who had them.
Damn.
Deep
dive. Do you think if we wiretapped people who had them, they'd occasionally be like, shit. Like on the phone with other people and be like, you know we had them, right?
If you hear your phone crackle, you probably because you had them and you didn't listen into it.
The feds are in.
You're going to have fucking Kerry coming from Homeland, dude. That's Homeland season 5, dude. We got to find
talking about we fucking had them.
Is Salt dead?
I don't know.
He's like, we gotta find out who had him, Kerry.
I don't know. All right, we didn't even talk Thrones, dude.
I know, man.
What do you think?
I mean, my favorite part of Thrones was when fucking the Three-Eyed Raven is in the chair and he goes to Sam and he was like, you have to spill the tea to Jon Snow.
Yeah.
He's like, the tea is so
I knew, dude,
the
hold
tea
on.
Is so good.
I knew you would love that moment, especially when he's like, you tell him, you're his brother. And
oh,
he's like,
dude.
What did he say? He's like, I'm not his brother anymore.
I'm not his brother anymore.
Like, he's just...
Yeah, he, dude, that guy is the fucking man, first of all.
You like the Three-Eyed Raven?
My favorite character.
There was two parts that made me laugh. One was when Tyrion... Is that the midget?
The midge, yeah.
The midge, when he was talking to Sansa up in that balcony, and then he just looked down the Three-Eyed Raven to some fucking weird kid in a wheelchair staring at him. And then when they showed like a wide shot of Cersei in the throne, and then the mountain standing at the mountain looks like such a fucking dickhead.
Crazy,
he's just standing there in the armor.
He's all purple.
He literally looks like a Minecraft character. Like he's just like the mountain. Yeah, the mountain sucks.
The mountain needs to die.
I hope the Hound gets a mountain this season. The Hound's the best.
Hound's the shit.
Dude. Hound's the best character.
I don't like how they're
Craster. Craster was my favorite.
Who's Craster?
The guy who had that house full of women that were all his daughters that he was fucking.
That dude is
Craster's the man. I think he's the king.
He might be the true king.
I think he's the White Walker king, though.
Nah, dude.
Yeah, dude. Craster was feeding all those. He was
the
feeding
White
the
Walkers. Might have been like, whoa, you were getting a lot of pussy.
Wow, you were fucking your daughters and then feeding us the kids?
You were manufacturing pussy? Yeah, dude. That was actually.
Craster's the man. Me and Weaver Craster. Used to love Craster. Dude, like, Craster. We'd be so hyped.
Craster's compound was fucking Craster's sick. Craster's compound. I don't like how they're entering into that whole, like, almost like Marvel-esque jokey dialogue.
I hate the fucking jokey dialogue.
Well, if you fall, it's like that whole, like, everything this lady, the hot lady, the Targaryen.
Yeah.
Anything she says now is like a cool verbal soundbite clip where it's like. Well, hold on. A dragon eats whatever it wants.
Yeah, whatever it wants. And then at one point, when they were, those dudes at the end were in like that hall.
Yeah.
And they like were looking for White Walkers and they popped out. And the one redhead, they were like, stay back. His eyes are blue. And he's like, my eyes have always been blue.
It's
like,
blue.
Dude.
Yeah.
Don't drop these like corny jokes.
Yeah, exactly.
In the middle of like a life or death situation.
Yeah, dude. That's been kind of lame. Especially, like I said, especially between the two. Queens or ever.
I actually said that to Clark last night. We were watching that scene where they were flying on the dragons together. Yeah. And I was like, is this fucking dumb?
Yeah.
Like, the shit I'm watching right now, I'm like excited to watch. Like, oh, they're going to fly on the dragons now in the snow world? Yes. Oh, they're in love on dragons?
Dude, even Brittany was like, this is kind of jokey dialogue. It's kind
jokey
of
dialogue is just
She's
takes me out.
She's a litmus test for corny TV. She loves it. She even her, even she was like, this fucking weird jokey shit's getting kind of old.
I was
like, damn. You fail her on some corny dialogue, bro. You fucked up. So yeah, that was one thing I was like.
And dude, Tyrion Lannister, the midget's fucking accent has bothered me from day one.
Well, he looks crazy. Now. You see him now? He looks like he lost.
He's trying to be hot.
Something, man. Yeah, he's trying, dude.
He's got like a rugged beard.
I'm in a Kingslayer, dude.
Kingslayer's the man.
I'm in a
Kingslayer's top five.
Kingslayer's my boy right now.
Craster.
Craster, R.I.P. dog.
Hound.
R.I.P. You were a real one.
Yeah,
R.I.P.
he was a real one, dude. He was feeding his male children to zombies and fucking
that dude
the moms.
Was just, all that guy wanted was to steer clear of a sausage party, dude.
He
can
just
you blame him?
Stayed north of the wall in a fucking sex den.
Did you imagine
guy ruled.
Staying out of a, like, just going into a sausage fest and just feeding all the dudes out until you're the only dude? You'd be like, that's party.
And then
now.
All everybody that was left was just your daughters that
I
you
mean,
kept.
That's just a necessary evil. In terms
that's
of
awesome.
Setting up
a. Getting new sniz, dude. He's planning for the future.
A lot of fucking, a lot of incest kicking. Like, I just, the series finale is going to be, are Snow and his aunt going to continue to bang?
Yeah.
Can they even rule together now since they're.
How about the one scene?
Can they just do, like, fucking hand stuff?
The Greyjoys? The people on the boats?
I thought they were going to fuck, too.
Remember when she tricked him and made him finger her?
Yeah.
And then was like, I'm your sister. Ha ha, got ya.
Also, it's medieval like, times, there's probably a lot of trickery like that. Like, you probably would inadvertently fuck your aunt constantly in medieval times. If one person cheated, no one knew, then it'd be like, oh, and everyone was in a small town, so you'd end up fucking eating your aunt's pussy at some point.
Without a doubt. I mean, you could run into that today at like a ruckus Christmas party.
Yeah, dude.
You might end up slipping and eating your aunt's pussy.
Yeah, especially when they start combining like third cousins and shit. That's a fucking, that's good getting, dude. That's
getting good. Getting. That forbidden love. That's just you good. Guys down there drinking eggnog in your uncle's basement.
Everyone's thinking it.
Everyone's
if you're at a family party, everyone's scanning. Everyone's
yeah.
Like,
they might even make some jokes. The whole family might make some jokes. Like, look at you two. You two want to fuck.
We should watch. Game of Thrones is a good icebreaker for just family party situations. You could be like, yo, how about that guy fucking his aunt? It's kind of weird. I mean, I don't know. It's kind of.
It's like, I get it.
I mean, if you were just like my aunt through marriage, it's not a big of a deal. They're aunt through blood.
Yeah.
It's his blood aunt.
That's his blood.
And the guy's fucking his sister. There's a ton of incest, dude. It's wild that like that got... I think it was kind of like... Was that only how many of the books were written before it came a TV show? So HBO execs might have been like, yo, RR, crank up the incest, bro. People are loving it.
You think? I think RR was talking. Like...
Or he might... He likes wolves and incest. That's the two things.
RR loves to toss in a M. Night Shyamalan incest twist.
For sure, dude.
Like, oh, you guys just fingered? Guess what? That was your fucking sister.
That's true. It must be weird at the family parties for RR.
The Greyjoys suck.
The Greyjoys are, yeah.
And I mean, yes, if you were RR's fucking niece, you'd be like, all right, steer clear of this fucking savage. No, that savage.
Dude is not invited to the fucking
Oh, that gross fat beard. And then in this chapter, the brother fingers his sister, and she tricked him into fingering her pussy on a horse. And then the dragons come, and then there's zombies.
End scene. Oh, my God.
I'm a billionaire now.
Yeah, dude. Fantastic.
Turns out this country's retarded. And that's the hit show.
It is a fantastic
show. I love the show. But
yeah, I was like, dude, chill with the fuck. Like, could they have just not fucked? Why do you have to keep making these people fuck their aunts and stuff? Although, you know, that is the stuff of mythology.
Those two fucking was sick.
That's the story of Oedipus,
that's,
dude.
That's, I mean, dude, that's Snow's butt.
What happened?
When he was fucking... What the fuck is her name? Danny?
Oh,
Daenerys,
dude,
you got to see Snow's butt.
Did we see his butt? Was that last season?
His cheeks at the end.
He's got a nice ass. Yeah, I kind of remember
thick
that.
Thick fucking ass. I remember motor, watching that nice and being motor, like,
dude.
All right.
He's got a nice motor, dude, to pump in on.
He's got a thick motor, dude. That thing was revved.
454, dude. Whew. Whew.
Oh, I saw...
Wait, what? I was watching. You know what I was watching the other day? Brittany started watching The Notebook in my while I was driving. She started... She's been like... I've been bitching about her backseat driving me. So she started watching, just like, she'll watch stuff now while we drive. First, I was like, what the fuck are you doing, dude? What if I put it in headphones while you drove and just listen to music? You'd be like, what the fuck's going on? But I was, she's like, well, I don't want to, you know, bother you. I'm like, all right, you know what? Fair enough. But I'm watching, I'm like listening to The Notebook, and they like haven't seen each other in 7 years, and they have sex, and then, and like Gosling's just pumping. I'm like, this guy would have came in like 10 seconds. I was waiting on some sniz for fucking 7 years, and I got it. I was like, oh, God.
Yeah, dude.
He like, he completely dicks her down in this house. I'm like, dude.
Obviously.
Come on, man.
Obviously, dicked her down.
But, sorry, go on.
I saw Us.
How was it?
It was good. I liked it.
You liked it better than Get Out?
It was probably better than Get Out. I just liked it more because not every white person I know was like, it's my favorite movie ever. I saw it 5 times.
Yeah, that's true.
Which they did with Get Out, which made me very publicly shit on Get Out every chance I had.
That was annoying. If you haven't gone to see it, I implore you. It was almost like voting in a way.
Yeah.
Like, I implore you to get out. Do yourself a favor.
Should have handed out stickers that said, I saw Get Out, so you could take a selfie with it.
Yeah, it was weird.
But Us was good. Check it out, yeah. There's one part that fucking annoyed me. It was one of those corny joke, like a joke in the middle of a crazy, intense scene where like, these people are breaking into their house, and they unlock the door. The front door is locked, and there's a family in there. They're like, leave us the fuck alone. And then you see the key start to unlock, and the wife is like, oh, the fucking hide a key. They found the hide a key. And the husband's like, what kind of white shit is that? And like, it's like, come on, man.
The hide a key?
Yeah. But it's just like to toss like fucking white ass bullshit. It's like, dude, there's a breaking and entering where your family's about to get murdered.
Yeah.
And you're going to toss out a fucking racial, like,
it's probably exactly
fucking white.
It's probably exactly when you toss them out. If I'm about to die, I'm instantly emptying all my racial prejudices in that moment. If people invaded my house, I'm like, what the fuck are the Jews up to?
Zombies are breaking into your house. You're like, goddamn Jews. Yeah, maybe.
But I hear you. That's super corny and like almost forced in. Of like,
yeah, like a bad hacky like white people be crazy joke.
White people be hiding keys on
Facebook. Hide a key? Come on, man. What kind of white shit is that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's kind of lame. It's super fucking lame. But it's also
Tim Heidecker was in it. That was funny.
Was Heidecker in there?
Yeah, he was good in it.
Was he really?
Yeah. There's a couple scenes where he's funny. Because just from Tim and Eric,
one of
he's
them
hilarious.
I told you, one of them loves butt stuff.
One of Tim and Eric?
Yeah.
Probably.
Did you tell me that?
No, I didn't.
So I knew someone who was going out there who was like dating one of those two and said like they will go out there and ream them with strap-ons.
Both of them seem like the type of guys that would like
who
a good attack.
Was I talking to? Someone told me that.
Not me.
Yeah, they're going out there and ream.
I did not have that info.
Okay.
That the Tim and Eric loved getting fucking pegged.
One of them does. I don't know which one.
Tim looks like he's got a nice little chubby little fucking tush, liberal dude. Body. He loves being super liberal. He's got a nice little tush for it. He talks
tush
like
is ready
real,
for the taking,
he
dude.
Talks like real cunty.
Yeah.
Did you ever hear when Sam Hyde called him?
What was he?
Because Tim Heidecker was one of the reasons Million Dollar Extreme
I
got
heard that, yeah.
Him and Gelman.
Yeah.
No, not yeah, Gelman. They, whatever. I always forget the guy's fucking name. They like kind of pushed Adult Swim to like kick Million Dollar Extreme off. And Sam Hyde calls Tim Heidecker on his show, on his like podcast.
Yeah.
And Tim, just the way he responds, he's like, well, I wish you the best. Good luck. Like shit like that. It's just like, dude, could you not be a pussy right now?
Yeah, it sucks.
Anyway. But what he was funny in it.
He is fucking hilarious. Their shit
Tim
is
Tim and
so
Eric
funny.
Is so good.
So funny.
And that's what was crazy about Million Dollar Extreme is like when they started, it was clearly Tim and Eric.
Yeah.
Like that was their clear fucking influence. Yeah. And then, you know.
They went to the dark side.
In the end, their heroes fucking killed them.
Happens, dude. You're fucking...
That's what happens.
Heroes becoming rivals, dude.
You got to AI them.
Rivals becoming rivals.
You got to AI them for your survival, dude. Wow.
Oh, my God, dude. So wow. What's up, dude? We're in an hour 10.
We got Thrones. Thrones is in the works. That'll be fun to talk about.
I know. I'm excited. Every week, I'm going to be on that, dude.
Yeah. What do you think's going to happen?
I mean, dude, it's like now that I didn't think they're going to give Snow the dossier that fast. That was the thing. It was like, dude,
when
Three Eyed Raven
the
gained the DOS and was like, dude, you got to go give him the DOS.
Three Eyed Raven is the DOS.
He is the dossier.
He's the non walking. Dude, he's
the
bearer
of secret knowledge. I think it's going to end with. I mean, Snow. I don't like Snow's the king. He can kill off. Dude, if Targaryen, if the dragon mother gets killed, that'd be pretty funny. That'd be pretty funny.
Yeah.
No one's really seen her get killed. Snow, I don't know, dude. I don't know if, like, Sansa might fuck... Because Sansa's now jealous that Snow's fucking his aunt. So she might suck Snow.
You also have to figure
Sansa
out...
Sansa might suck
Sansa
Snow.
Might bum. Sansa's so hot. You also have to figure out who... You got to keep in mind that whoever gets killed in this is going to become a fucking White Walker. Which is going to be sick.
That'd be tight, yeah.
So a bunch of these, I hope the midget becomes a White Walker. He'll just be a funny looking...
He'll be a dong biter, dude.
Yeah, he'll be biting dongs, dude. And then he's going to run into the eunuch.
He'll have
a little stare down, yeah.
Shit.
See, that's my... I think the redhead dude, you know,
he's
going to be a White Walker.
For the White
and
Walker,
he's going to fight that big, tall, blonde lady.
Is she still alive?
Those two like each other, yeah.
You think they're going to buck?
I think they might have... Or they liked each other.
She might have strap attacked him.
She might have attacked him. But I think that's the one thing I'm prophesying.
I could see that.
A showdown between the redhead dude and the big tall blonde lady.
Yeah, dude.
That's the only thing I can see.
I hope the White Walkers win. Tell you the truth.
Yeah, that'd be sick.
That'd be tight if the White Walkers just won.
Yeah.
Be awesome. It'd be awesome at the end. Or the end is just R.R. Martin's dong, dude, coming in for us.
I hope at the end it turns out this is in some shitty part of the world that we haven't discovered yet, and then the U.S. military shows up.
That would be fun.
Just fucking. I hope the Navy SEALs win.
Just come in. That'd be cool.
That'd be
the
awesome.
The troops come in and win.
I hope at the end they're like, oh shit, it's the troops.
It's the fucking troops.
And the
dude.
Troops just fuck everyone
That'd
up.
That'd be fantastic, dude.
If Trump drops a bomb, if Trump nukes them,
be Moabs them, dude. That'd be tight.
That'd be one.
We'll
that's,
see. I mean, again,
that'd be a sick ending.
They did Moab the one time. The one lady has Moabs.
Yeah, true.
So,
but was that all the Moabs?
That was a lot of it, yeah.
I think that might be all the Moabs.
Shit. I don't know. So I think, again, there's going to be some more incest, I'm sure. Sam might molest his kid.
That baby?
Yeah,
that's Craster's son, dude.
Sam might molest
that's
that
the son of Craster.
A son of the Craster?
Yeah, he was one of the babies. That was about to be fed.
He's an incest.
Sam's son incest is bastard. Craster's boy.
Sam might fucking...
I think Craster's boy is the true king.
You think so? He's just like generations of... Possibly.
Yeah.
I don't have any good predictions other than, like I said, my only prediction is an ending where the whole Stark family penetrates each other simultaneously and the White Walkers explode.
That's what it takes?
Yeah. For the Three-Eyed Raven to project the fucking shit that kills the White Walkers, he needs to get snow.
Oh wait, he can project things that kills him?
He might. But I think he has his hidden power.
Remember that where they were throwing like magic balls at the zombies?
When
they ran into the cave, they became the three-eyed raven. When he ran into that dude that was stuck in the tree.
Stuff? Yeah, they can't
fuck with him. They had like magicians throwing.
Of course. He's a fucking three-eyed raven, dude. You can't fuck with dragons, not with magicians. It's a package deal. But I think I'm trying to think how to work it out. Like, if Snow were to enter Sansa and then... They'd have to human caterpillar with genitals in order to destroy the White Walker. The Starks have to all literally unite physically. Yeah. If they do that. Or if it's like...
Well, now it's not incest.
Who, the Stark with Snow?
Snow.
Yeah, but Snow has to plug his aunt. His aunt has to be the end of the chain. And you could also throw Cersei and her brother on there, too.
Maybe Sansa and Snow will fuck now that they're not related.
Wait, they're still related. No, they're not. They're the same mother.
No, they're not.
What? Oh, is their aunt?
Yeah.
Ah, they're second cousins. Fair game.
Wait.
they're fucking related, dude.
Oh, wait.
John can't fuck anyone in Winterfell. Fuck any hot chicks in Winterfell. He's related to all of them, dude.
Who was Snow's mom?
Maybe it was Ned Stark's sister.
I think it was...
Yeah, it definitely wasn't his wife. He didn't get cucked. His sister. His sister bucked the king.
And was dying.
And then he was like, I'll protect your boy.
Yeah, all right.
So, her dad and her cousins.
Okay.
Which is really nothing.
They weren't.
A little bit of cousin action in Game of Thrones world? Nothing, dude. Fair game.
I just want to see Sansa get plugged, dude. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, she's had like some pretty terrible runs.
She had a rough go.
Yeah. She doesn't look like she really has much sex on her mind right now.
No.
Seems kind of beset like by political.
She's a sexless bitch.
Yeah, dude. I think if all of the incestuous parties combined into a incestuous centipede, they might stand.
I think that
could be the wall, dude. The White Walkers are like,
ew, this isn't even cool.
This isn't even funny.
Is this what you guys do down here? I hope the mountain plugs Tyrion.
Damn. He might make him explode.
Yeah.
Oh, no. His dick, you know, his face is all blue and shit. His dick's probably so veiny, dude.
Definitely, when they put him back together like Frankenstein, they gave him the thickest, blackest dick.
They might.
Nice. Dude. That's Game of Thrones talk.
Yeah. Dude.
That's how you talk
Thrones.
That's
how you talk Thrones, dude, for sure. That is so fucking funny.
All right. We should.
Yeah, let's
stop.
Do it, bro.
May 11th. Come to Helium. Oh, old Maddie McCuskey is doing a little guest spot May 11th. And then O'Connor, I think O'Connor's featuring.
Nice, that'll be awesome.
Trying to get Beezer on there too. I don't know.
That'll be fun. That'll be a good old time.
Yeah.
May 11th. Also, dude, my bad about the. I tried to get the Patreon episode together. Had all kinds of technology issues I didn't foresee. I was like trying to figure out how to record it, how to do this, if I was going to do it off of like, you know, Google call and screenshot. I'm still bucked up on it. So technically I was working on it, but didn't finish it. Just stay tuned. It's basically my Yandi, dude. Just, you know, let it be what it is. And, it, you know, when people go on, they're like, oh, I'm going to take my money. It's like, dude, take your fucking dollar. I don't give a fuck. So let that be what it is, bro. I can't be fucking controlled by money, dude. I'm sorry. It's my flaw. Yes, I have it. I cannot be controlled. I'm sorry.
Yeah, dude. Don't fuck the money up.
I'll fuck the money up, bro. I'll
burn fuck the down. Money up, dude.
I don't give a fuck.
Yeah,
dude.
Me neither.
Burn this shit the fuck down.
But
to people who do, fucking. My thing is, I want to completely take the business thing out of it. I just want to make the podcast. People like it. Give us a dollar. If you don't want to give us a dollar, fucking don't. And this whole like enter into these weird contracts of like, but I'm paying $250. It's like, man, get that shit the fuck out of my face, dude. Donate that shit to somewhere else.
What do you mean?
If you're gonna like try to hard money me, like, well, I'm taking my shit out. It's like, take it away, dude. I don't.
Oh yeah.
This is
well,
a quid pro quo, dude. You're just if you want to be a patron, dude, and fucking that's, dude, that's what it was back in the day, dude. CG Jung, if you wanted to follow a course of study, you had to be well liked enough so you could find a patron and be like, can you pay for my college, sir? And if no one liked you, they'd be like, fuck you, dude.
We had
just throw a fucking dollar. If
you that like was it, our that was our thing up front. When we first had a Patreon, we were like, just give us a dollar if you like the show.
I don't want to run fucking ads. I don't want to do any of that shit. I just want to get and talk my shit. If you like it, give me a dollar. If you don't, if you like it, don't want to part with a dollar, don't part with the fucking dollar. I don't give a shit. But I don't want to enter into the fucking business realm of all, like, I'm not doing that, dude.
Yeah.
Don't try to fucking buy. You can't buy me, dude.
You might be getting
bought out.
You
can't fucking buy me, dude.
You sure?
Yeah, dude.
All right.
How?
How?
I talk the wildest shit, dude.
You just talked about reparations, dude. Your reparations ideas stink.
No, they're great. They're great. Find out who had them, bro. I've been saying that from day one. Find out who had them. You had them, you got to pay.
Now you pay?
You got to pay.
All right.
Or they could do Kickstarter reparations.
Yeah, start a GoFundMe.
But it's like...
Go fund them. If you had them, you got to go fund them.
That's a go fund them, dude. Yeah, we'll see what happens.
All right, May 11th, Helium Comedy Club. Come out. God bless you.